Let's talk to Dr. Rakib Ehsan. How much trouble is Boris in your view, Rakib?
Well, I think he's in a fair bit of trouble, Mike. If you look at the polls, the Labour have now Labour has now developed some quite handsome leads in some of the recent polls, and but Boris's the Prime Minister's favourability ratings are very low, and I think it's quite remarkable, really, that I think, to be honest, only Boris Johnson could lead the Conservative Party to its largest parliamentary majority since 1987. I think there was one poll in the earlier stages of the pandemic where the Tories were polling at 55%, which is quite remarkable. And then within 2 years, he's facing calls to resign. You have Tory associations in places like Sutton Coldfield. They're pretty much no intention of backing him any further, calling for him to step down. So I do think that he's in a fair share of trouble here.
Yes, I think so. What's your bet on what happens over the course of the weekend? Because obviously there's an awful lot of those people in the media, an awful lot of people in the world of politics who think that there's more scandal to come out. He's kind of on his last legs, isn't he now?
No, I'd say so. And I think that the interesting thing here is that Brexit could have been framed as a catalyst for democratic renewal. I think you'll see that one of the strongest factors driving the Leave vote was institutional distrust and being dissatisfied with British democracy and the way politics works in this country. So I do think that if we're looking to heal the relationship between the state, political institutions with British citizens, I don't think that Prime Minister Johnson is the man to spearhead such an initiative in the post-Brexit world.
And what are you seeing as the next emerging leader for the Tories? Who is that going to be?
I'm not entirely sure who that would be. I think that Rishi Sunak, the Chancellor, would be up there. Liz Truss will be up there as well, I'd imagine, in such a contest. But I think the key thing, if the Prime Minister was to step down or be ousted, I think the new Conservative leader will really have to do a fair bit of healing. And I think that you can even see now that there's a notable portion of Tory voters who wants the Prime Minister to step down. So I think that really what the next leader has to do is focus on the bread and butter, introduce a degree of competence. I think
Well,
that
that would
the
help.
government's not ranking well on that sense either.
No, exactly right. Rakib, good to talk to you. Thanks very much indeed. Dr. Rakib Ehsan, research fellow at the Henry Jackson Society.